Well, the Lakers weren't able to land Anthony Davis in a trade yesterday, but confidence is still high in La La Land. I love that movie. All right, after their big road win against the Celtics, Lakers GM Rob Pelinka told Spectrum Sportsnet, quote, "I wouldn't want to play us in any seven-game matchup, and that is for sure." The Lakers are currently just outside the playoffs in the West. Chris Broussard is still with us this morning. How good are the Lakers right now?
You know, there's a part of me that wonders if Rob Pelinka thought that quote was off the record.
Wait a sec.
Let's get there first, get to the playoffs first, which I think they clearly will. They're a game and a half out of eighth, but the place you want is seventh because they cannot be Golden State.
No.
I don't care what, they can't be Golden State. But anybody else, we've seen every year in the East, LeBron doesn't need a ton to beat most teams. And I think he's got more help than he had last year. I've said, I think we've agreed all year. I think they can beat any team in the West outside of Golden State. Now, I think Houston and OKC are probably better. But, you know, given time, by the time they get to the playoffs, if the Lakers don't get hurt, they haven't been healthy all year. Not just LeBron, but Rondo.
Especially for any length of time.
Right. So if they can get better chemistry and Rondo, look, I know you love Lonzo, and I still think he can be a good player, but Rondo's better. At this point, Rondo is better, and we know playoff Rondo gets even better. He was huge in New Orleans. That's one reason they've fallen off.
My point about Lonzo is I just want him in the rotation. They'll be better with him in the rotation. He and Rondo played together a good bit.
I give you that, and that's part of being healthy as well. Get Lonzo healthy. I like the additions. I was surprised they gave up Zubac. I got to admit, I think he was their best offensive big.
Yeah,
but
Muscala, he can shoot threes.
He can stretch.
And they have no big who can stretch.
Right, yeah. So that makes up for it. And Bullock is, I mean, you look at statistically, he's their best three-point shooter. Because volume, he shoots almost seven a game, which anybody on the Lakers shooting close to that much is hitting a much lower percentage. So I think those additions could help. They got to get to seven, though. That's the key. And the Clippers are coming down. You know, they're about to fall. Sacramento's
young. They're waiting till next year.
Right. Sacramento's young. You can overtake them, but you have to get to seventh or, you know, it's going to be over and over early. And I think they could get to the conference finals if they can avoid Golden State. Mm.
Consistency has been their problem all season long. I agree with you. They can't beat Golden State. No. Not in a one-game series, not in a 10-game series, not in a 20-game series. Mm. They're not beating Golden State. I like them. The teams that I like them best against, OKC, Portland. Yeah. I like them against
them. I think Denver. Like, Denver, as good as they are, they're 14-13 on the road.
Yeah.
And nobody there has been to the playoffs.
Right. The thing is,
and I take LeBron over them.
Back-to-back nights on the road. They have been nuts.
Right, Brooklyn. Good.
Now, but they can shoot you out in their building now. But when they streaky. Now, you talk about streaky. They get on the streak and they shoot 20, 25 threes. The thing is that when you do have LeBron, you always have a chance. My concerns are, is that what I know what I'm going to get from LeBron. I know I'm going from LeBron, though. But what about the other guys?
Do I know
what I'm going to get from Kuzma and Ingram in a playoff series? I don't know. So to say, Rob, I know you're feeling good. That was a big win, especially after you got the brakes beat off you in Indiana without their best player, Victor Oladipo. I get it. Feeling good. Oh, nobody wants to see us. Everybody like, yeah, we do. Actually, we do want to see you. Yeah. Now, maybe if you had Anthony Davis, maybe that'd be a different story. But you don't have him. Skip, they just too inconsistent for Rob Pelinka to jump out there without a boat. And say, nobody wants to see us. Mm. I know what LeBron represents. In the East, nobody wanted to see him. In the West is a different animal, and he's playing with guys with the exception of, Tyson Chandler, who comes off the bench, JaVale McGee, who played, 10, 15 minutes a game, and Rondo. Mm-hmm. Nobody else has really playoff minutes, Kim.
Okay, my turn.
Okay.
Our NBA expert, Chris Broussard, said, 2 days ago, there is 0% chance that this trade would go down. And he was dead right about that. And I kept hanging in at 51-49. because I had wishful thinking that LeBron would be able to flex his muscle and somehow make this happen. And the reason, full disclosure, I wanted this to happen is that I'm not a big Anthony Davis fan. And I wanted to see him and LeBron and a gutted LA Lakers team try to make a run through the playoffs because I don't think they could have. I'm here to submit that Dell Demps passed up by far the best package that will be on the table. I know you got all worked up the other day and said this is garbage, you know.
Yeah, and that garbage was an overstatement.
Okay,
yeah,
but you were just going barbershop. Yeah, you were all worked up, and I get that. I like these kids to varying degrees. I like them a lot. There's star quality in Lonzo, in Kuzma, as we saw again last night, even in Brandon Ingram. They have guts. They know they're good, and I don't think moments will be too big for them. So my point is, I think they turned off better for this year's run by keeping everybody intact. This team is a little better now than it would have been gutted with Anthony coming. Because then LeBron and Anthony have to sort of figure each other out.
Right.
And
I think it would have taken time. And Anthony, who would have been around
him? Okay, who would have been around him? But Anthony would be a good fit with LeBron just because he idolizes him and he would play second fiddle to LeBron without complaint. So I think they would have been a good duo together. But I don't think this team would have been better than it is right now. I like this team. And I frankly love it that Rob Pelinka made that statement. You can say full of himself, carried away, maybe off the record. I loved it because I think it rings of truth to me. When I first heard it, I thought, you know what? I don't think Golden State would be real comfortable going up against at full strength, with everybody healthy and with all the cogs in place and the chemistry flowing. He's right about this because they're deep, and I'm talking about the nice little moves of Bullock and Muscala. This is a good basketball. It's not a great basketball team, but it has obviously one great player. And when you have that great player, you do have a chance.
But you need, but beat Golden State. You need a bunch of great players.
Right? Okay. You're saying Golden State?
Yeah. Well,
should be afraid of them too.
This he issued a challenge to me to Golden State after last night. Carried away. Euphoric.
He was off the record. This morning he's like, I said he's calling Bresnahan like what?
I don't know. It was on. Wasn't it on TV that he said?
Good thing Golden State wasn't listening. Golden State, I hope you were asleep. Well, he didn't say what
Golden
he said.
Golden State was. They'll be listening.
He was misquoted.
Yeah.
He was misquoted.
Why not throw down a challenge? Why not say, hey, we're not afraid? You think this team would be afraid of Golden State? What happened on Christmas Day? Help me out. What happened?
One game.
Oh, yes, well, what happened?
You look. Rob Pelinka was misquoted. If Charles Barkley can be misquoted in his autobiography, even though we got the audio to hear him say it and the video. He didn't mean
the book.
It. Yeah, he didn't mean
okay,
it.
Okay, Skip.
This team is a little better off right now than it would have been with Anthony Davis.
You may be right because, again, who knows what would have been around him. However, let's say next year, do you think this team as it is better off with what they have rather than trading it for Anthony Davis?
Well, then you can start in free agency where you don't have to give up anybody if you don't want to.
You're going to have to give up something to get Davis.
I'm saying there are a bunch of other free agents. Are they going to ignore LeBron or join him? I don't know.
I don't think they're getting it. I think what they may need to do is if you can trade for Anthony Davis, add Jimmy Butler. Because I don't think they're getting – there are a lot of people around the league starting to think maybe Kyrie – but I don't think they're getting Kyrie, KD, or Kawhi, or Clay. I think Jimmy Butler. Now, Philly, there's talk that maybe they're
Not getting Clay because if KD leaves, they're going to max Clay out.
They'll max it, which they should, because they won't fall off the map.
So are you sure KD wouldn't join his friend LeBron James in L.A.?
I think KD wants to be better than LeBron. Right. I think he wants to beat LeBron. That's why I think it's the Knicks with Kyrie or the Clippers with Kawhi if he leaves Golden State.
There's speculation about the Clippers. Okay. Well, is it possible LeBron's going to be all dressed up with nowhere to go and Hollywood?
AD. And like I said, Jimmy
KD
Butler.
KD can go to the Clippers. KD can go to Brooklyn. He can go to the Knicks. The Lakers get AD. He going to do what he did when KD was in Oklahoma City. Okay. Put him across the knee. Now go to your room. Hey, 17 and 5.
Remember.
Whoa. Hold on just a second. What happened the last two finals?
What did I just say?
Did KD turn LeBron over his knee?
No.
He did twice.
No.
He shot it right in his face 2 years ago.
I mean, he had a lot of help. He had a lot of help.
How you gonna go somebody beat you up? They beat you up, and then all of a sudden, you go get them to beat somebody else up.
What did Chris Broussard say the other day? If you're in the park and you're picking guys, and there's Draymond, there's Clay, and there's Steph, you're like, those guys, right?
No, before KD went there,
yeah.
Kevin Love, Kyrie, LeBron, yeah. Steph, Clay,
Draymond. Wait a minute, but Draymond.
People would take.
Hold up, but remember,
no, you're right. They beat him.
They got hurt, Kevin Love
right.
and Kyrie.
I give
was
you,
hurt.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You're right.
Well, he almost right. beat him. He should have beat him without any help. He was up 2-1 in his house. Game four was in his house. Huh? Andre Iguodala winds up being the MVP.
Yeah, because he held LeBron James to 35-13.
Should have been Steph. Oh.
Yes.
Andre Iguodala shut down the king in his house?
Stop it.
Well, I'm starting it.
Think about it.
I want to know.
Yeah, right.
35-13
at numbers
nine.
Were crazy.
Really?
Oh, you guys can go all day. Chris, thank you for being here today. We're going to switch gears just a bit from the NBA. The Chiefs, are they making a big mistake with Patrick Mahomeboy? We'll discuss everything that...